Hi guys, welcome to Daily Technical Forex Forecast for the 14th of December. My name is Andrew Olshanetsky. I am a technical analyst at TradeInfoFix. And as usual, we begin our forecast with the USD currency pair. Yesterday, the price showed a strong growth. You see that the growth of the price was supported on large volume, by large volume, and it contained large ask deltas. It means that big players were buying at that moment, so buyers were dominating the market, so that we can consider it as a local reversal signal. So more likely that this local downtrend is over and now the price will rise. Also, we need to point out the new support level which was created during this move. It's 1.1784, 1.1793. This level contains a large volume here, so that it can be used as a good place for putting our stop loss. The scenario of trading is pretty simple. We need to wait for a smooth correction of the price to the level in order to get a better entry point. Then we open long positions. A stop loss should be placed not below the level of support but below the strong bullish impulse, so here. And then we wait for the growth of the price. A potential of the deal is around 100-110 pips. So for the euro, long positions are in priority. Similar situation for the pound, as the price grew up strongly yesterday. Growth of the price was supported by increased volume and the new level of support was created. It's 1.3370, 1.3381, which also contains a large volume, so that we can consider scenario of opening long positions. The same scenario, we wait for a smooth correction of the price down in order to get a better entry point. Enter the market here, opening long positions. A stop loss should be placed below the strong bullish impulse, so below this level. And after that, we wait for further growth of the price. A potential of the deal is the resistance 1.3544. So for the pound, also long positions are in priority. The yen, the price has finally broke down the previous support, and you see that the breakdown move was abrupt and supported by increased volume. Also, we need to point out the new resistance. It's 112.72, 112.86. This resistance contains large volume, and you see that the price is testing it at the moment. So if the pair shows a strong rebound of the price down after the test of this level, we can open short positions here. A stop loss should be placed a little bit above the strong bearish impulse. A potential of the deal is around 100-110 pips. So this is our target. So for the yen, after the strong rebound of the price down, we can open short positions. The Canadian dollar. Situation is pretty difficult for trading right now, as the price is locked in the local consolidation below the level of resistance 1.2906. Yes, it fell down sharply yesterday, but the fall of the price was an average volume, and unfortunately volume was spread throughout the move, so we can't point out fresh volume levels. And really, now I don't see any good scenarios for this currency pair. That's why I advise you to skip this instrument from our trading plan today. The Australian dollar, great situation here. The price broke out the previous level of resistance here, and also it was the upper limit of the local consolidation. You see that the growth of the price was abrupt. It was supported by large volume you see that big ask deltas were there, so it means that buyers were dominating the market. And of course, given all these factors, we should consider opening long positions for this instrument. Moreover, the new level of support was created. It's 0.7614, 0.7626. This level contains large volume, so that it can be used in trading as a good place for placing our stop loss. The scenario is pretty simple. We need to wait for a smooth downward correction of the price. After that, we open long positions. A stop loss should be placed below this strong bullish impulse, so below this level. And then we wait for continuation of the growth. A potential of the deal is more than 70 pips. So for the Australian dollar, long positions are in priority. And our last instrument is gold. Well, situation here is pretty tough, as the price is locked in the consolidation. you see that yes, it showed a pretty abrupt growth, and growth was supported by increased volume, and there were large ask data. So of course it seems like buyers were dominating the market, but given the presence of the strong downtrend for this instrument and the strong level of resistance right there, now at the moment I don't want to open long positions. I want to see the further continuation of the growth and the breakout of this level of resistance, and only after that we can consider long positions. Now at the moment we should stay out of the market and wait for the breakout of the boundaries of this local consolidation. Let's take a look at the sentiment of the market. Well, here we can see that our scenarios for the yen, for the pound, for the Australian dollar are confirmed, so these three instruments should be in priority today for gold and for the yen. You see that the sentiment is unchanged, so we need to get some additional signal in order to be able to trade these two instruments. For the Canadian dollar, you see that long positions are still in priority according to this indicator, but given that the price is located in the local consolidation, we should stay out of the market for the Canadian dollar. So overall, there are a couple of good scenarios on the market right now. So in case of acceptable entry points, we can trade this currency pairs. And by the way, I want to warn you that today there are a lot of fundamental news, so we should be extremely careful. And of course, before the news, we shouldn't trade any currency pair because it is too risky. So for today's all. Thank you guys for watching. Hope this forecast will be useful for you. See you tomorrow. Bye bye.